know, it might not be the result the Rangers wanted about not playing in the playoffs, but for Lafreniere.
Pastrnak, stopped by Kinkaid on the feet from Marchand. I think Kinkaid's shaking up.
Yeah, I think he's hurt. I mean, he did the splits is what it appeared to me.
Here comes Jim Ramsey, longtime athletic trainer for the New York Rangers, up to 10 Kinkaid, and you can see in some discomfort here. The pass by Marchand, and then right there he gets overextended and in a wishbone position there, and just immediately knowing he's in discomfort.
And I didn't know earlier on the Richie goal in the second period, I thought Kinkaid got up a little slow as well. I don't know if something's been bothering him, but yeah, he gets in the splits right there. And the worst thing for a goaltender is when you just have, you know, some issues with your hips or groins and you're just not 100%, and yeah, Shesterkin's coming in, and tough spot for him, sitting for nearly 50 minutes of the hockey game to come in ice cold. And for Kinkaid, I'm sure he feels terrible about doing this, but he will be the goalie of record if Shesterkin is able to hold it where it is and Boston not able to score a goal. Kinkaid would be the guy that gets the win in this hockey game, but he moves from his right to his left, and then the split. Yeah, and I've been there as a goaltender. Like I said, if you have issues with your hips or groins and you get into situations like that, you try to protect yourself as much as possible, but sometimes it's just impossible.
11:10 remaining, 3-2 Rangers.
Everybody would be in front of their bench right now. They really like this guy, Bush.
Igor Shesterkin replaces Keith Kinkaid in goal for the Rangers. Kinkaid has got off to the locker room. Rangers scoring twice on consecutive shots. 2 minutes, 4 seconds apart earlier in the period to take a 3-2 lead.